Hey everyone, so I've been going through and watching a bunch of interviews with Nikola Motors CEO Trevor Milton, and I've been analyzing what he's saying versus what the company's actually doing, and how what he says in different interviews changes over time. So anyway, I just wanted to do a quick dive into the differences between what he's saying and what's actually coming true. So let's get started.
Nikola finally allows people to make paid reservations for the Nikola Badger. It's the coolest electric truck, pickup truck the world's ever seen. So
you mentioned it's the coolest pickup truck the world has ever seen. The world hasn't really seen it, has it, Trevor?
No.
I mean, what?
I love it. Usually I'm the one that has to call people on that sort of thing. But listen to this interviewer just like, hey, actually, the world hasn't seen it. And look, he owns up. Look at his face. Look at that smile. He goes, no, they haven't. Like, he says that. He's like, oh, no, you caught me. They haven't actually seen it.
At what point will the world actually see a truck and one that can operate as opposed to seeing mock-up pictures?
This is what I've been harping on for months now. It's like taking pre-orders where people are paying actual money for this truck, and all that they've seen, all they have to go off, is some pictures on a website that are just computer-generated images. They're not real pictures of a real truck. This is a great question. Good job, interviewer.
Well, we haven't made a truck. We actually made the most advanced semi-truck the world's ever seen. We showed it off last year driving on fuel cell. We made deliveries with Anheuser-Busch. This is our big semi-truck, so the technology's all done.
Okay, look at what he just did there. She asked him a question about the Nikola Badger, which is the pickup, and he immediately evades the question and goes to, well, look, we've actually made a truck. Look at our semi. And while it's true that they have made semi-prototypes, they haven't actually mass-produced the semi yet. In fact, they're just starting the groundbreaking for their factory in Coolidge, Arizona, that's going to be manufacturing the semi. So saying that they've made the semi isn't even fully fair. I mean, it's true that they've made a prototype, but nothing you could actually sell to customers. But even that's all a ruse, him trying to get out of the question, which the question was, when do people get to see the Badger, which is their pickup? And he just dodges it. He just totally dodges the question.
Yeah, we haven't showed it off to the world, but that's the fun of it. The next 4 months, everyone's got to wait. They got to get in line. And Monday, the reservations open. And in December, they'll all get to see it in person. So all the critics will...
Maybe it's just because I'm a natural-born skeptic, but this attitude really rubs me the wrong way, which is just that pre-order it, so buy it now, put money down now for something that you don't get to see till months in the future, but give me your money for it now. And yeah, I promise it's going to be good, but you can't see it till later. There's just something about me that makes me think of like a snake oil salesman, because I'm just like, I just don't trust it. Now, when the truck is revealed in December and we can see and we can test if it's good, then I'm all for ordering it then. But the idea of paying for something that you don't even know what you're getting to me, it just doesn't sit right. But anyway, that's just me.
Was it in fact a sort of a fake truck show in 2016?
I mean, the answer was every part on that truck was functionable. We just didn't feel safe driving it at that time.
Okay, I'm not trying to split hairs over the definition of functionable, but I would say, at least for a vehicle, not being able to safely drive from point A to B might not be functionable.
It was all operable, but it wasn't really that safe. Like, it could have killed someone in the audience.
Yeah, I take it back. That's not functionable at all.
Okay, so between now and December 3rd through 5th, when Nikola World happens, you're asking investors to basically say, we believe you.
Ooh, that's a big oof.
In terms of your timeframes for delivering these vehicles, whether it be the Nikola One or the Badger, we believe you in terms of the reservations turning into actual orders.
Oh, she's getting right to the heart of it.
What can you tell us, though, in terms of tangible progress towards meeting production targets, whether it be who you've partnered with for the Badger or what stage you are in the manufacturing process?
What a great question. I really like this interview. She's not shying away from the questions we all want to hear answers to.
Yeah, so we got a couple of big things going on over the next 4 or 5 months that'll give a lot of comfort to people. One is we have our factory in Ulm, Germany with Iveco. We did a joint venture with them. We have the first ever zero emission semi truck coming off the assembly line right now, hand built units.
Okay, I'll give it to him. Credit where credit is due. People are worried that they're not going to be able to manufacture these semis, and he's saying, look, I'll show you when they come off the assembly line. That's a good answer.
The Nikola Badger, I'll be leaking certain videos to the public as well when they're, you know, it's all about the lead up. I mean, the 4 months all the way into, well, I guess, however many months until December, that leading up into that is the excitement. So we don't want to give it all away at once, but we'll be announcing who's going to build the Nikola Badger with us in the next couple months.
Okay, so at the end of June, Trevor is saying in 2 months, a couple of months, we'll be able to announce our partnership, who we're going to build the Badger with. And then 1 month later, he says,
within a couple months prior to Nikola World, which is December. So here in the next 2 months-ish was what when we're really hoping to be able to announce that partnership.
Okay, so this really isn't that big of a deal, but all it's saying is like, Trevor at the end of June was saying it'll be 2 months till we announce that partnership. And then at the beginning of August, 1 month later, he was saying it's going to be 2 months before we do that partnership. So it's like it'd been 1 month, but he moved his goalpost 1 month later. So not that big of a deal, but something noteworthy.
There's going to be a lot of data, a lot of leaked videos.
Okay, this is a small point, but if you intentionally release a video, it's not leaked. That's intentionally being released.
You can concede, though, Trevor, that proving the critics wrong involves actually not just making videos and talking about these fantastic technologies, but actually putting them to work. So there's a little bit of skepticism amongst your critics at this point, because everything or many things that you're promising are still promises, even though they are there and they're promising technologies.
Can we get a slow clap on that one? Now, unfortunately, we don't really get a very satisfactory answer to that question. You can go watch the full-length interview if you want to see it, but it wasn't that interesting, so I'm not going to play it. Anyway, so that's what my research shows, and thanks for watching the video. Let me know if you have any comments, and I'll see you in the next one.